Well, hello everybody, it's time to make time, and I'm taking some time today to hang out at Riverside Municipal Airport, Riverside, California. It's one of the things I love to do the most, is just hang out at the airport and gawk at airplanes. And the one I'm gawking at today is this beauty right here. The Flabob Express. Flabob is an airport that's just a little bit north and east of here. If you've never been, it's like taking a step back in time. The reason that this beautiful aircraft is here is Flabob's runway is being resurfaced. I'm not sure how long that's going to take, but in a future video, I will take a flight over there and walk around and show you all the cool stuff and why I love that little airport. It has so many great memories for me. Flew there, been flying there for, I don't know, 25 years now. But let's take a walk around this beautiful airplane here. It's first glance, you know, it looks just like the DC-3. This particular one was manufactured in the 40s, I want to say like 45 or 46 or something. But this is a Douglas C-47 Bravo. And no idea what the Bravo is for. But the civilian version of this was built and designed as a military transport back in the 40s. But the civilian version is the DC-3. But the Flabob Express. And I had a chance to talk to one of the pilots a couple weeks ago when this first landed here. And it's here because Flabob's, again, the runway's being resurfaced. So they're going to keep it here for a little bit, which is a treat for me because I'm normally at this airport flying around and hanging out. And he's telling me that Winston Churchill and his family were flown around in this aircraft back in the day. And I think this is one of the things I love the most about aviation is there's so much nostalgia in it, you know, from Octave Chanute and Leonardo da Vinci. Yeah, da Vinci, the painter, or the artist. and when flying was started out with gliders and everything else to the Wright brothers and first powered flight and Kill Devil Hills, North Carolina, all that fun stuff. And there's so much cool history to it, to modern fighter jets now and this beauty from, I don't know, 60 plus years ago. I'm not good at math, 60 something years ago. And to see this thing, you know, restored and maintained and still flying and wow, I love stuff like this. You know, you got those modern airplanes that with streamlined glass cockpits and everything's automated and relatively speaking super easy to fly, and then you go inside this beast, there's 1,001 switches and knobs and levers. But it's cool, it's all part of the heritage of aviation. And that's why I love it so much. Plus it's cool to fly and chicks dig pilots. That's what I tell my wife anyway. She rolls her eyes. But looking at this thing to see that who's been in this airplane and that it's still flying around. Super impressive. Love it. Love it, love it. But yeah. See why I nerd out about this stuff. And we'll finish off this video with this cool jet taking off. It's hard to tell which one's cooler. I don't know. Today, I think the Flabob Express wins, but I'd certainly like to find that jet that just took off too, so. All right, you guys have a great day.